Right, this is our beginner series level one. It consists of 20 drills. We're gonna run Jordan through them real quickly right here. You can work out right with them. You wanna focus on, first of all, having fun when you do these dribbles, working in speed. Speed one is 50% repetition, proper mechanics. Speed two is 75% repetition, proper mechanics. And speed three is out of your comfort zone. Repetition, proper mechanics with intensity equals gain success. We want Jordan to really focus on maintaining his stance. He's gonna do 10 reps at speed one, 10 reps at speed two, and then 10 reps at speed three. All right, the first one we're gonna do is a ball slap right here. Give me 10 ball slaps at speed one. Just stay slow for me, Jordan. Maintain proper posture. Keep his head up. He wants to keep his back straight. All right, keep going, speed two. You speed knees up gradually. You're gonna speed them up gradually with them at home. All right, we're gonna work to speed three. Come on, push it, bang, bang, hit it, good, good. Got to have a good handle as that ball comes in. Got your 10? Good. Now he's going to come up right here. We're going to do a lot of stuff to get our kids familiar with the basketball at a young age and stay shoulder width apart. I'm going to do a behind-the-back wrap with his right hand, starting at speed one. Speed one is 50, Jay. Good. All right, now take your next 10 to speed two. Tell me when you're at three. You call it. Now posture. Good. Back straight, back straight, back straight, Jordan. Try not to hunch up. Always working on our kids maintaining proper posture and having a knee bend, even there. Now let's take it the other way at speed one. Here we go. Speed one is 50% again. Your speed one may not look like this at first. You might fumble with speed one. Speed two, a little bit faster. His speed one's a little bit faster than the average fifth grader. Good. All right, now he's gonna go to that head wrap. All right, good. Keep your head up at all times. Try to keep your head still. Try to take out head movement. Talk a lot about that with shooting. But we want to do it right here, stay as still as possible. He's in speed two right now. Now he's working into three. When you're working for speed, working into those speeds really helps you get faster. Let's reverse it the other way. Now, Jordan, start at one. Start at one. Slow it down for him a little bit more. Good. Good. This is kind of a rest for him, okay? Working on repetition with proper mechanics for speed one. Now he's working into two. Good. Take it to three. That a boy. Come on now. Push yourself. Every day, yeah. See how he gets right back in? Makes the mistake, doesn't play around, doesn't walk to the ball, hops back in. Good job, good job. Now we're gonna go waist head at speed one. And it's still an upper body part here, good. Our younger kids we don't have them lifting weights in fifth grade, but what we do have them doing is some ball wrap stuff because we think it's good for our younger kids to help them build some endurance and stamina and make them stronger with their ball. He's at three right now, he's working at 10. That a boy, come on now. It's all right, get tired. All right, you start to make mistakes. How are you gonna deal with adversity? Good, let's go left. We like to teach our players at a young age how to deal with adversity. Things aren't always gonna go your way. Good, come on now. Working into three, he's getting tired. You get tired, the drill gets hard. The drills will be killing me about right now, just like they are him. Good, get your 10, get your 10.
this video, you will learn several exercises to help you pivot. Pivoting is a fundamental skill in basketball and is often misused by beginners. The exercises are divided into two parts, pivoting while standing still and pivoting after receiving the ball. First, pivoting while standing still. Assume the triple threat position with the ball in your hand. Pivot forward 90 degrees using your left foot as a pivot, maintaining a shooting position. Return to the basic stance, rotating backwards with a reverse pivot, still using your left foot to pivot. Perform the same exercise, pivoting on your right foot. Repeat the exercise, this time pivoting 180 degrees. During the exercise, always assume a shooting stance at the end of the turn. In a game, this will allow you to shoot quickly. Make sure you're always well-balanced on your feet. During games, this will mean you can start dribbling or make a good pass. Secondly, pivoting after receiving the ball. Stand with your back to the basket inside the three-point line. Pass the ball to yourself beyond the three-point line and turn back to face the basket as you catch the ball. To pivot inwards, use the foot closer to the basket as a pivot. Alternatively, to pivot outwards, use the foot furthest from the basket to pivot. You should finish the movement in a well-balanced triple threat position with both feet turned towards the basket. Practice these exercises slowly at first to get used to the movement, then try doing it faster as you would in a game situation. Over to you.
Kyle Korver is one of the greatest three-point shooters.
I still see your shadows in my room. Can't take back the love that I gave you. It's to the point why I love and I hate you, and I cannot change you, so I must replace you. Oh, easier said than done. I thought you were the one listening to my heart instead of my head. You found another one, but I am the better one. I won't let you forget me. I still see your shadows in my room. Can't take back the love that I gave you. Love and I hate you, and I cannot change you, so I must replace you. Oh, easier said than done. I thought you were the one listening to my heart instead of my head. You found another one, but I am the better one. I won't let you forget me. You left me falling and landing inside my grave. I know that you want me dead. I take prescriptions to make me feel okay. I know it's all in my head.
Rebound. Korver tries it again.
I have these lucid dreams where I can't move a thing, thinking of you in my bed. You were my everything, thoughts of a wedding ring. Now watch it blow in the wind. I should have listened to my friends. Leave this shit in the past, but I wanted to last. You were made out of plastic, fake. I was tangled up in your drastic ways. Who knew evil girls had the prettiest face? You gave me a heart that was full of mistakes. I gave you my heart and you made heartbreak. You made my heart break. You made my heart ache. You made my heart break. You made my
steps the pass to Korver.
You won't believe it! The audacity! Can't take back the love that I gave you. It's to the point why I love and I hate you, and I cannot change you, so I must replace. said and done. I thought you were the one listening to my heart instead of my head. You found another one, but I am the better one. I won't let you forget me.
Right there.
Start. Miles with the leaner. Andre with the rebound. Steps to the wing. Guns for three. Won't go through. Andre. George Hill. Off iron. Andre boards it. George to the baseline. Shots off the heel. Andre corrals another rebound. He has five. Five Miles. Shot won't go. Andre's tap will though. Baseline to Rodney. Step back gun, short over Blake. Andre with another rebound. Stanley Johnson leans over Stanley, fires no. Andre way up for the rebound, like that's mine. And Andre back on the court. Reggie to the rim, no. Andre with a follow, yes, rebound. Rodney Stuckey misfires. Andre took it away. He's got a double-double, 12 and 10. Andre with a rebound. Paul George. This is the reverse. Andre boards it out. Lydia Silva couldn't tap it. Here's Andre. Paul George with the drive. Contested by Andre. Made a miss and pulled the rebound down. Four. Marcus Morris lets it go. Got off the rim. Andre gathers in the rebound. Three off the front. Follow-up book won't go for Ilya Silva. Tap Andre and then another. And this one is down. Andre with rebound number 21. Avoy Allen from outside. Andre with a rebound. Reggie to the rim. Andre with a rebound. Miles. A long two around and off to Andre. Offside's going to be short. Rebound off the deck to Andre. He has 25 and 25. Short. Andre with the rebound. He's tied his career high with 26 rebounds. Hill with a follow, no. Andre with a rebound.
Hello and welcome to Lockdown Defense. I'm Coach Mike, and this is part two of our defensive stance series. These are the techniques we've learned after years of study, the techniques that will improve your game and one day make you a lockdown defender.
Man, oh man, what a defensive play.
Tremendous defense.
Wow.
So when it comes to the defensive stance, we believe there are two types of effective ones. In our first video, we covered the forward stance. In this one, we're going to break down the upward stance, which is characterized by very little bend in the knees and hips. You're almost standing straight up in the defensive stance. This is going to allow you to better contain the ball and stay in front of it. A great stance for those who don't want to give up anything easy, or who maybe aren't as explosive as the man they're covering. It gives you the ability to keep space and keep recovering, very similar to the stance used in soccer to contain the dribbler. But in basketball, we're allowed to use our hands. And in this stance, your wingspan expands side to side, so that when a dribbler tries to get past you, you should have the reach to poke into his dribble pocket. And remember, the key word is the poke. You're just trying to get a hand on it and tip it behind them so that you can chase it down for the steal. Understand that this only works if they try and penetrate right by you. If they take a little wider of an angle, you're gonna need to slide to get in the right position. And although it might be really cool to pick someone's pocket, what's more important is protecting the basket. And when describing the proper footwork in this defensive stance, I'm going to have to steal a quote from Greg Popovich. Just keep backing up. Because as a defender, your job is to make it hard for your opponent to score. And if you stay between him and the basket, every shot attempt he gets is going to be contested. And if you stay in front of him long enough, maybe he'll pass it or make a mistake. And if not, you can still try and make a play at the basket. And don't get me wrong, this stance doesn't have to be completely passive and on your heels the whole time. You can be aggressive with it. You just have to make sure your slides are quick and you don't drop your hips and give your opponent an angle to the basket. Notice how Pippen never drops his defensive stance at an angle. He's always moving backwards or side to side. This is a great stance for those guarding very explosive players, or perhaps those who don't have enough conditioning to use the forward stance. And feel free to mix it up and let me know in the comments below how it goes. Because remember, great defense isn't always about making plays, it's about preventing them. As always, I'm Coach Mike with Lockdown Defense. Keep up the hard work.